If you are preparing for a data science interview, then you have to see this. What is this? Here's a set of SQL questions that are similar to the ones asked in an Amazon data science interview. And we're gonna walk through the solution one step at a time. Let's get started. What up guys, this is Dan, interview coach at datingintro.com. In this video, we're gonna go through easy, medium, and hard level difficult questions that are similar to the ones asked in Amazon data science interview. Now, to kick off the problem, let me start by introducing the data sources that we're gonna need. We all know that Amazon's flagship business is the e-commerce where the consumers can shop for goods online. So the data sets are based on this. We will need three tables: the Amazon users table, Amazon products table, Amazon transactions tables. The Amazon users table contains information about the users. So it's the user ID, first name, last name, email, country, join DT, prime member, prime, join DT. The Amazon products table contains product ID, product name, category, price, rating, and published at. And finally, the Amazon transaction table contains the transaction ID, user ID, product ID, transaction DT, payment method, shipping cost, and quantity. Now we also need to understand the relationship among the tables. The transaction table is the base table, and there are many to one relationship between the transaction and product table, with the common key being product ID. Now in terms of the relationship between transaction table and the user table, there's also the many to one relationship between those two tables, with the common key being user ID. Now with this information, we're now ready to try out the practice questions. Let's start with an easy level question. For each product category, which product is the most expensive? I'll put the category, product name, and price. Only return one item per category, even if the prices could be the same for multiple products. Let's start by deconstructing the question that's being asked to us. What we need to understand is that for each category, there are multiple products, and every product has different price points. Now, keep in mind that some of the products might have the same price. And so when we're trying to get which product has the same prices, we may end up having multiple products. So in that case, we only care about one of those products and not all of them. So that's going to determine what type of ranking function we're going to use. Now on Daetama, we also get information about what is the expected output. In this case, we need category, product name, and price. And in terms of the source table we need to solve this problem, we're going to need the Amazon products table. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have a subquery. And this subquery is going to give us the rank or the row number partitioned by the category, which is ordered by the price in the descending order. So what this basically means is that within the category, you have multiple products and different prices, and we're going to apply the ranking function on the products such that the one with the highest price is going to have a row number of 1, and then the one with the second highest is going to have a value of 2, and so forth. Now this is also going to remove the situation where we have two products with the same prices, and instead of having the same rank value that could be come from the rank function, we're just gonna use row number, which is going to ensure that we only have one of those product be assigned with the value 1. And we're going to name this rank function the price rank. And I'll wrap this under the subquery called rank table. Now that I have the subquery, next thing I need to do is apply filter on the price rank field where the value is equal to 1. And this is going to ensure that I get the following output, where for each category, which product was the most expensive, and also get the category, product name, and price. So when I execute this, I'm going to end up with the right solution. Voila. By the way, if you want to follow along and try this question out, you should check out Daetama, an SQL practice pad with Fang-style SQL questions solved by data scientists at Google and Meta. Let's take a look at the next problem, which is a medium level difficulty. Among Prime users who purchase products in the clothing and jewelry categories, I'll put the email address in the ascending order of their Prime signup date. So let's start by deconstructing this question. What this basically means is that we only care about users who are Prime members. So obviously, we're going to need to use the Amazon users table, which contains information about whether they're a Prime member or not. And we also care about what products they purchase. In this case, we care about products that are found in the clothing and jewelry categories. And we eventually want to output their email address in the ascending order of their Prime signup date. So a lot of this information clearly suggests that we need all three source tables. We need to use the Amazon users table to know whether they're Prime member or not. And we also need it because we need to get the prime join date, which we're going to need it in order to sort the table. And we also need the Amazon products table because the product table contains information about for a given product ID, what type of product it is. And then we need a transactions table to help us get the information about whether a particular user had purchased this product or not. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to build a subquery. So this subquery is going to filter users who are Prime members only. Now, I care about what transactions they have for this user. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to join it to the Amazon users on the user ID. And I'm going to use inner join in this case because the inner join implies that I only care about users that had actually had some activity on Amazon. Now, it's not enough to just join the subquery to the Amazon transactions table. I also need to join it to the products table because the product table contains information about the product category. So you could see that this is the type of problem that requires multiple joins, and you could certainly expect a question type like this in Amazon interview. And the next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to apply filter. So now that I have joined all these three tables, I have the category field, and I'm going to filter it on products where it belongs in the clothing and jewelry category. And then the next thing is to apply ordering. So I'm going to order it on the prime join date in the ascending order. And finally, in terms of the output, what I need is the select distinct email prime join DT. Now you might be wondering why I have the distinct keyword. And that's simply because when you apply inner join and you have multiple users who might have purchased multiple items across various product categories, the output might have multiple instances of the email address and prime join DT. And so you need to apply the distinct in this case to basically ensure that you don't have duplication in the output. So as an example, suppose that I have a user ID of 1, then what could happen is that in the output, I have Danley, and clothing, because I had purchased 2 products that are clothing. And so the distinct in this case is going to ensure that it flattens it out, so I only get Danley and clothing. So if I run this and submit it, I'll get the right solution. Voila. The next problem is a hard level question. For each user, what's the most popular payment method used? If a user has multiple methods with the same count, output the method based on the first transaction. Return the email, payment method, and count. Let's start by digesting this question. What we need to understand is that for each user, they might have used different payment methods. Some might have used debit card followed by Apple Pay and so forth. Now, what we care about is the frequency of that payment method, but we only care about which payment method they use the most. Now, of course, there are some instances where you might have the same payment method in terms of the frequency. So what we need to do in those instances is only regard the payment method that was used first. In this case, in order to figure that out, we need to look at the transaction date. Now, what we also care about is the output in this case. So we need the email, the payment method, and the payment counts. And the source tables that we need to solve this problem are the Amazon users table and the Amazon transactions table. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to, instead of using a subquery, we're going to use a CTE. Now, for those who are wondering, when should you be using subquery versus CTE? Well, it depends on the complexity of the query. If you, in the interview setting itself, generally you want to write a query that's readable. If you're expected to write a query that might require multiple nesting of subquery, so let's just say at a minimum 2, then you may want to just swap that and use a with clause instead to simplify your query structure. So that's what I'm going to do in this case. I'm going to use a with clause. So the first block that I'm going to have is a group by. I'm going to group by the transaction on the user ID and payment method. I'm going to count the number of payment counts, and I'm going to ensure that I pluck out the minimum transaction DT, which is going to ensure that I remove the duplication cases later down the road. And I'm going to call this with block the user transactions. The next thing we care about is the ranking. So the first thing that we need to consider is that we want to rank within the user ID. And that's what we apply for both the payment counts and the first purchase DT. Now, in terms of the ordering of the rank, for the payment counts, we want to order it in the descending order because we want to ensure that the rank value of the most expensive product has a value of 1. But for the first purchase DT in this case, we only care about the payment method that was used first. So we want to ensure that the first purchase DT that came first is applied with the value 1. So that's why we want to have the ascending keyword. Now we're using rank in this case because the rank is going to ensure that two items that have the highest count are going to have the value 1. So when you apply rank in that case, then you're going to have a value 1 for both. So how do we go about filtering that? Fortunately, we have that second condition where we're applying rank on the first purchase Daetama. And this Daetama is broken down all the way into seconds. So this is going to ensure that no two payment methods in terms of its properties, in terms of the count and the first purchase Daetama are going to be the same. And so now that this ranking temporary table has been created, what I'm going to do is I'm going to join it to the Amazon users on the user ID because the Amazon users table contained the email address. I'm going to filter this table based on the payment method equals 1 and purchase order equals 1 and return the final fields, which are going to be email, payment method, and payment counts. So when I run this, I will get the right answer. Voila. So there you have it, guys. Here are the examples of the easy, medium, and hard level questions similar to the ones asked in Amazon Data Science Interview. Now keep in mind the interviewers are not only looking for whether you can write a query effectively, but they're also looking for how you can explain it. So if you're looking for examples like that, make sure you click this video and this is going to show you what is a bad response and what's a great response. So make sure you check this out.